The Senate has moved to the period of amendments for the Maharlika Investment Fund Bill after proponent Senator Mark Villar cut short interpellations on Monday. On Tuesday, senators gave recommendations for amendments. In the Terno and Contra speech of Senate Minority Leader Aquilino Pimentel III, he insisted that the bill should be tackled by the Senate Committee on Government Corporations and Public Enterprises instead of the Committee on Banks, Financial Institutions, and Currencies. Pimentel also asked why the Senate is in a haste to take on the measure, given the absence of a national emergency.
Whose idea was the Maharlika Investment Fund? Saan ba nanggaling ito? Is it possible that we are doing this as a favor to a businessman who has access to the ears of the powers that be?
I believe poverty is a matter of urgency. It's a matter of emergency. Anything that we can do to create more jobs, to bring down the poverty level, deserves that kind of certification.
Voting 16-2, the Senate junked Pimentel's appeal to refer the MIF bill to another committee for further hearing. In the Senate's version, funding for the MIF could reach up to 500 billion pesos. 125 billion pesos will come from the Land Bank, Development Bank, and the Central Bank. The provision mandating SSS and GSIS to contribute to the fund has been omitted, but senators are questioning a section which allows government financial institutions and government-owned and controlled corporations to invest. This gives way for the GSIS and SSS to be involved if approved by its board of directors.
Ang appeal ko talaga sa aming lahat sa Senado ay at the very least, magpasok ng amendment na yun na nga po, forever i-assure ang mga miyembro ng GSIS at SSS na kanila atin ang pondong iyan at hindi yan hahawakan o gagalawin ng gobyerno.
Sabi ko na, support ako dyan dahil wala na yung GSIS at SSS. Pero ngayon, meron palang isang provision doon sa ilalim na nagsasabi na pwede mag-invest. Siguro, hindi lang ako siguro mag-attempt na i-amend yung particular provision na yon.
Former Central Bank Deputy Governor Diwag Ginigundo sees this as a loophole for the two institutions to eventually be involved in the investment fund. Ginigundo has opposed the provision from the get-go and added that for the investment fund to produce a high rate of return, it will need to be aggressive. And aggression in investment usually leads to more risk, which the SSS and GSIS should avoid.
Kung ikaw ay namamahala ng mga institutional funds, you tend to be more conservative. It is possible only if they shift from being conservative to a more aggressive stance of investment strategy. Baka dahil sa ganitong mas aggressive ang kanilang investment strategy, baka maging delikado yung pondo ng SSS at saka ng GSIS. Ang pondo niyan ay para sa pensyon ng ating mga retiradong kawani ng ating gobyerno at ng pribadong sektor. Kawawa naman kung halimbawa isa, dalawang buwan, tatlong buwan, apektado sila.
Finance Secretary Benjamin Jokno said the public has nothing to worry about.
Panic ka na naman yung there's no basis for that.
Right now, ang may mga restriction ang SSS and GSIS kung magkano pwede nilang invest outside. I feel giving them an opportunity to invest in an infrastructure project. No? Always ito, nabawa, nakikita ng 20% return. Bakit po naman sila bagong babawalan?
Concerns on using dividends of Land Bank, Development Bank, and the Central Bank were also raised as it could lead to an increase in taxes and added national debt if the government runs out of money for priority programs.
Dalawa lamang o tatlo lamang ang maaaring gawin ng gobyerno upang ito ay makapag-compensate o makabawi doon sa mawawalang pondo. We have to be prepared. Not only to pay a higher level of taxes, yung pagbabayad ng mauutang para ipampuno doon sa mawawalang pondo na ibibigay naman sa Maharlika Investment Fund.
With the absence of a surplus fund that will justify the MIF, Ginigundo says it is a redundant measure. as different government agencies have existing development funds to address programs that MIF will cover. Former Finance Secretary Gary Teves urged the government to take time to look into the Maharlika bill as there are more pressing matters the government should attend to.
Kung sana meron silang pagkakataon pa, dapat tingnan muna mabuti yan. Mas mabuti yung matanong natin, ito ba ay importante at urgent? Sa tingin ko importante, pero hindi urgent. Kasi compared sa inflation, mas importante yun tsaka mas urgent. Kasi yun talaga, yun ang pulso ng taong ngayon based on the survey of SWS saka Pulse Asia. No? Mas importante and urgent pa nga yung concern sa anong gagawin natin sa pensyon ng those in military uniforms kasi makaka-affecto sa ating fiscal operations po yan.
Lady Vicentio, ABS-CBN News.